Hello and welcome to today's live 6:30 broadcast of music here in Worcester. You join me once again in my home office where I'm sat in front of my digital piano. Now, many of you will have heard in the last couple of days of the sad death of Jennifer Bate, who was one of the leading organists in this country, especially when it came to the music of Olivier Messiaen, that brilliant French 20th century composer. And in fact, she was considered one of the foremost authorities on Messiaen's organ music. She was Messiaen's organist of choice for the last 20 years of his life, and when he composed a number of epic, large-scale and complex works. And hearing of her death a couple of days ago made me think of a very small personal connection that I have with Jennifer Bate and also, to an extent, with Olivier Messiaen. Now, I never met Jennifer Bate, but the link comes through Muswell Hill in London. Jennifer Bate's father, H.A. Bate, was the organist of St. James's Church there, and that is therefore where Jennifer Bate grew up and subsequently lived. Also in Muswell Hill, resident in Muswell Hill, was the larger-than-life music critic Felix Aprahamian, who died in 2005. In addition to his wonderful music criticism and writings on music, Felix Aprahamian was a great impresario, and all across London, his house in Muswell Hill at number 8 Methuen Park was really a hotspot for all sorts of music makers and audiences to go and have a party and also have more serious meetings as well. And the guest book there is a who's who of 20th century music making. The house itself is absolutely remarkable, packed to the brim with musical instruments, with scores, often signed by the composers who had sent them to Felix Aprahamian, his letters and correspondences with various composers, and his many, many music notes and writings and recordings. Now, perhaps unexpectedly, one of his frequent guests was Olivier Messiaen, and he would often stay in the house in Muswell Hill before going into London to hear a UK premiere of one of his organ works given by Jennifer Bate, who lived just round the corner. And I recall a wonderful photograph of Jennifer Bate and Olivier Messiaen stood in the garden of 8 Methuen Park, with Messiaen jotting down on his notepad the birdsong that he was hearing in this corner of London. And the link to me, you might be wondering, well, in a very small way, I have a link to that house, because since Felix Aprahamian's death in 2005, the house has been taken over by the Arabesque Trust, led by a wonderful group of trustees and David Aprahamian Liddell. And as part of their activities, the 3 bedrooms in the house are rented out to young musicians looking to make their way in London. And I was fortunate enough to live there for a year just before I moved to Worcester when I was working in London. It was an incredibly inspirational experience to live in a house with a remarkable number of musical instruments, 2 pipe organs and 2 grand pianos, quite apart from anything else, this vast array of scores of letters, of books, of writings, and also to know that you were part of this great 20th century and 21st century history of music making. I was told that the room I was living in for a year was the principal guest room and where Messiaen himself would sleep when he came to visit London. So with all that in mind, I thought I ought to play something by Messiaen for you today to mark the passing of Jennifer Bate. Now, I must be honest, and whilst I play a selection of Messiaen's organ repertoire, his piano music was more unknown to me as a performer. So I've had a look and found a set of preludes that he wrote really quite early on in his life and compositional career, These were composed between 1928 and 1929, and Messiaen later said, when reflecting on his career, that these preludes were the first pieces that he wrote of any real worth. Now, each prelude has an associated programme and associated colour, and I'll be playing one of them for you today. This one is entitled Calm Plaint, which is translated as a calm a complaint, a calm lament. And the colour that's listed is a smooth grey with reflections of mauve and green. Thank you very much for joining me tonight. Please do join us once again tomorrow at 6:30 for another musical performance.